Yeah, I would like to talk about the effects of VLD on reproduction because they are huge effects. We all know, I think, that worldwide, BVD virus is one of the major causes of infectious diseases related to reproductive losses. And we all know what does this mean, economic losses. Decreased the conception rates, which leads to decreased pregnancy rates, abortion, stillbirth, weak neonates, congenital abnormalities, are present in herds infected by BVD. But if, for example, acute infection of BVD virus can cause ovarietis, can cause impairment of follicular function. Thus, the exposure of a cattle prior to estrus, prior to insemination, can lead to a diminished conception rate due to delayed ovulation or failure to ovulation. While the infection of a cow or of a heifer in the first 30 months of gestation produces the death and resorption of a really high proportion of embryos. And the only sign that we can see is that the cow goes back, returns to it in a normal cycle, or at least in a prolonged interval cycle. While the infection of pregnant animals in the, let's say, 50 to 100 days of gestation can result in abortion or mummification of the fetus, but surely a huge proportion of these fetuses, up to 70%, can survive, and when they will born, there will be a new PI, a new persistently infected calf in your herd. There is also the possibility of transplacental infection from, let's say, 120 to 150 days, and this will lead to congenital abnormalities. These are cerebellar hypoplasia, for example, or ocular abnormalities, or there could be the birth of young calves with maybe smaller and with a curly hair coat. And there are also the description of abortion or stillbirth or weak neonates when infections occurs in the last period of gestation. So we work very hard every day in our herds to achieve a high reproductive performance, and I think we cannot allow BVD virus to ruin our job.